And we have our seven astronauts seated at breakfast. Ilan Ramon is there. He is the representative from the Israel Space Agency, a first-time flyer, as well as David Brown, William McCool, who will be our pilot on this mission. Our commander for this flight is Rick Husband. Laurel Clark, one of the two females on this mission. Mike Anderson. And of course, Kulpna Chawla, rounding out the seven-member crew. This again was taken at the crew quarters. Astronauts have been awakened at different times. They're on two separate shifts on this mission to cover the 24 hours that we'll be doing scientific research. Crew members are, of course, in their suit-up room. First one is Rick Husband, who is, of course, the commander of this flight on his second flight. He was selected as an astronaut back in 1994. He flew on STS-96 in 1999, spent 235 hours in space. William, or Willie McCool, is our pilot on his first flight. He was selected by NASA as an astronaut in 1996, and on this mission, he'll be responsible for maneuvering Columbia as part of several experiments mounted in the shuttle's payload bay. Mike Anderson. He's the payload commander as well as mission specialist on this mission. This is his second flight. He first became an astronaut back in 1994. His first flight was STS-89 to the Mir space station. Laurel Clark, mission specialist on her first flight. She too became an astronaut back in 1996. Her first assignment was to work in the astronaut office payloads and habitability branch. David Brown, mission specialist, his first flight. He was initially assigned to support the payload development for the International Space Station. Kulpna Chawla, mission specialist, and she was the prime robotic arm operator on STS-87 back in 1997. This is her second flight. And Ilan Ramon, colonel in the Israeli Air Force. He's the prime crew member for the Mediterranean Israeli Dust Experiment. And back to our commander. This is a crew coming out of their crew quarters as a unit on the third floor of the operations and checkout building. All of our astronauts, of course, are now suited. And they are getting onto the elevator that will take them down to the ground floor and to the astronaut van, which is waiting for them. Our astronauts coming out now as they are making their way to the astronaut van. Commander Rick Husband, payload specialist Ilan Ramon, pilot William McCool, and mission specialist Michael Anderson, David Brown, Laurel Clark, Kopnachapa. Commander Rick Husband, as he is currently in the white room at the launch pad making his preparations to enter the vehicle. Rick Husband is a colonel in the U.S. Air Force, and again, he is the commander of this mission. He is the senior member of the red team. This crew of seven are divided into two teams, the red team and the blue team, and each will be taking 12-hour shifts to conduct around-the-clock experiments. During this mission, he'll be maneuvering Columbia as part of several experiments in the shuttle's payload bay that will focus on the Earth and the Sun. And of course, as commander, he will take the stick and land Columbia back on the end of its 16-day mission here at Kennedy Space Center. And the NASA test director, Jeff Spalding, has given approval for the crew to begin entry into the vehicle. Commander Rick Husband, the first to enter the orbiter, as is the tradition and the custom for the shuttle commander, and he will then be followed by his fellow crew members, each taking their seats in the orbiter's flight deck and on the orbiter's mid deck. And we have a camera that is stationed on the flight deck, as we can watch the crew members climb into the vehicle and take their seats. Of course, for the next 2.5 hours prior to the opening of the window, once they're in their seats, they will be basically laying on their backs in a prone position, and you can see Husband climbing in somewhat difficult, cramped quarters there. He has astronaut support people that are assisting him, and they will continue to assist him and the other crew members until they are all completely strapped in. And next to enter the vehicle will be the astronaut representing the Israel Space Agency, Ilan Ramon. Ramon is a colonel in the Israeli Air Force. He received a Bachelor of Science degree from the University of Tel Aviv in 1987. Ramon will be situated and seated on the mid-deck. Three of our astronauts will be on the mid-deck, and four will be on the flight deck. As we see Ramon get on board the orbiter Columbia, back in 1997, the Israeli Air Force selected Ramon as a payload specialist, and then in 1998 he reported for his first training at the Johnson Space Center. He is the prime crew member for the Mediterranean Israeli Dust Experiment, or MEDEX, a multi-spectral camera that will measure small dust particles in the atmosphere over the Mediterranean and the Saharan coast of the Atlantic. He'll be working with a number of other experiments, including the ESA Advanced Respiratory Monitoring System, water mist fire suppression, and structures of flame balls at low Lewis numbers experiments, as well as other experiments including physiological and biochemistry studies. Ramon is a member of the red team and will be the prime crew member for the MEDEX experiment, and he is currently taking his seat on the mid deck. Back with a view of the white room, we have our pilot, William, or as he likes to be called, Willie McCool. This is his first flight, and he'll be a member of the blue team. McCool was selected by NASA as an astronaut in 1996, and he was initially assigned to the computer support branch. On this flight, he'll be responsible for maneuvering Columbia as part of several experiments that are mounted in the shuttle's payload bay. He'll also I'll be working with experiments, including the European Space Agency Advanced Respiratory Monitoring System, or ARMS, and he'll be assisting Ilan Ramon with the Mediterranean-Israeli dust experiment.
OTC, OVCC.
Go.
Yes, sir. PLT is aboard.
Copy PLT at 1307.
And with that, the pilot has now made his way through the crew hatch and is making his way up to the flight deck, where he will take a seat next to the commander, who is already on board and in the process of conducting voice checks. Now, once the commander and the pilot are seated in the flight deck, they will again perform a variety of communications checks and begin the process to reconfigure the cockpit control switches as necessary for the final hours of today's countdown. The orbiter seating arrangement for ascent for launch today will be on the flight deck, Husband, McCool, Brown, and Chavla. And then on the mid-deck, as we see here, will be Anderson, Clark, and Ramon. Now, this view from our strap-in camera is of the mid-deck again, and we have two of our astronauts, of the three that will be on the mid-deck, Ramon and Anderson, of course, have taken their seats, and they will soon be joined by Laurel Clark. Back in the white room is our mission specialist, David Brown, and he's taking his turn to be suited up and make his preparations to enter the vehicle. This will be his first flight, and he is a member of the blue team. Four of the astronauts are on board, and three are waiting to board right now. David Brown and Laurel Clark are seen here in a view together in the white room as they await their turn to get on the vehicle. Standing by now for the entry of David Brown into the orbiter. He'll be taking his seat on the flight deck. He'll be sitting directly behind William McCool, the pilot. And mission specialist number one, David Brown, has just joined the other astronauts on board Columbia, and he is finding his way to his seat on the flight deck at this point. And Laurel Clark has entered the vehicle as well, and she is sitting on the mid-deck. We have one more member to join the rest of the astronauts on board. A view of the mid-deck, we have seated all three astronauts. The astronauts, in the order that we're looking at them, is Ilan Ramon is actually sitting closest to the camera, Laurel Clark in the middle, and then Michael Anderson to the back of the screen.
And all stations on air to ground, verify all systems are ready for crew module closeout.
OTC, OVCC.
At OVCC.
Yes, sir, MS-2 is aboard.
Copy MS-2 at 1343.
And the last of our seven astronauts has now entered the vehicle, and Kalpana Chawla is in the process of getting into her seat on the flight deck.
Check